Imagine a jazz album so iconic that it not only defines an era, but also stands the test of time, resonating with every generation. That's The Caddy for Daddy by Hank Mobley, a classic just released in the Blue Note Records Tone Poet series. And we are going to dive deep into this classic today, so stay tuned. Picture this, an album so iconic. It's like a time capsule, capturing the essence of an era and still resonating today. That's the newly released Tone Poet series classic, A Caddy for Daddy, by Hank Mobley. And today we are taking a deep dive into this classic album. But before we take that dive, please smash that like button, subscribe to my channel, and hit that notification bell. Recorded on December 18, 1965. At the Van Gelder Studio in Englewood Cliffs, New Jersey, A Caddy for Daddy wasn't released until mid-September of 67. The 60s brought a gentle wave of hard bop, blending the lively beats of bebop with soulful bluesy whispers. A Caddy for Daddy beautifully captures this blend, offering songs that touch the heart while dancing with complexity. Its heartfelt tunes and rhythms echo the signature sound that Blue Note Records lovingly embraced during that time. Now, let's meet the legends behind this masterpiece. Hank Mobley, an American jazz tenor saxophonist, emerged as a defining voice in the hard bop and soul jazz scenes. His recordings, especially with the iconic Blue Note label, are celebrated for their melodic richness and rhythmic finesse. Collaborating with luminaries like Miles Davis and Art Blakey, Mobley's style was both smooth and deeply soulful. Despite being somewhat underrated in his time, his legacy has grown, marking him as a pivotal figure in jazz history. Curtis Fuller, a master of the trombone, carved a niche in the vibrant world of hard bop, leaving listeners spellbound with his musical prowess. His collaborations read like a who's who of jazz, with legends like John Coltrane, Art Blakey, and Lee Morgan. With a tone that gracefully shifted from strong resonant notes to soft, gentle murmurs, Fuller's solos showcased both innovation and heartfelt emotion. Trumpeter Lee Morgan was a beacon of the hard bop movement. Bursting onto the scene as a teenager, he quickly became a key player at the renowned Blue Note label. His hit The Sidewinder not only showcased his virtuosity, but also became emblematic of 1960s jazz. Tragically, his life was cut short, but Morgan's fiery playing and innovative compositions have solidified his status as a jazz legend. Pianist McCoy Tyner was warmly recognized for his contributions to modal jazz. As an integral part of the John Coltrane Quartet, he played a key role in crafting some of the most memorable jazz pieces of the 1960s. Tyner's unique left-hand chords and imaginative improvisations added a fresh dimension to jazz piano. His lasting impact has solidified his place as a cherished figure in the annals of jazz. Bassist Bob Cranshaw was known for his wide-ranging contributions across various jazz subgenres. Over his extensive career, he collaborated with numerous artists, from Sonny Rollins to Ella Fitzgerald. Cranshaw's adaptability and consistent rhythm made him a sought-after musician, leaving a lasting imprint on jazz bass playing. Billy Higgins was an esteemed drummer, celebrated for his impeccable rhythm and dynamic playing style. Often touted as one of the most recorded drummers in jazz, he collaborated with a plethora of artists, including Ornette Coleman and Lee Morgan. Higgins' ability to seamlessly blend into various jazz ensembles while adding his unique touch solidified his legacy as a drumming maestro. Now let's talk about the music, and up first is the title track A Caddy for Daddy. Please listen closely and tell me what you think in the comments below. A Caddy for Daddy is a delightful jazz tune that highlights Mobley's expressive saxophone melodies. Morgan's lively trumpet moments blend seamlessly with Fuller's gentle trombone touches. Tyner's piano, Cranshaw's bass, and Higgins' drums come together in a harmonious backdrop, embodying the heart and soul of Blue Note jazz. The song is a beautiful dance of instruments, weaving a story that's both vibrant and touching. Next up, the second tune on side one, The Morning After. Please listen closely and tell me what you think in the comments below. ¶¶ Morning After is a song that feels like a fresh start. Mobley's saxophone sounds like the first rays of sunrise, bringing warmth and hope. Morgan's trumpet carries a hint of cheerfulness, and Fuller's trombone adds a touch of thoughtfulness. With Tyner's gentle piano, Cranshaw's soft bass, and Higgins' steady drums, the tune feels like a peaceful morning walk. It's a song that tells a story of moving forward with hope after a challenging time. Now, let's talk about this album. I own both an original Liberty pressing, and also the Analog Productions reissue that was released in 2009. Both are in impeccable condition, yet the moment the needle touched the vinyl on this tone poet, I could hear the difference. Mastered using the original analog tapes by the legendary Kevin Gray at his Coherent Audio Studio in LA, this tone poet was pressed on 180-gram vinyl at the Record Technology Incorporated, or better known as RTI. The high-gloss tip-on jacket was printed at Stout Ton Printing Company in California. Wrapping up, A Caddy for Daddy isn't just tunes and rhythms. It's like a gentle stroll down memory lane, a nod to the rich tapestry of jazz, and a heartfelt present to all who listen. This tone poet reissue, lovingly crafted by Joe Harley, feels like a warm embrace, connecting us to the cherished moments of jazz's past. Every time it plays, it's a reminder of the care and passion poured into it by the tone poet himself. Did you enjoy this musical journey through the world of A Caddy for Daddy? We'd love to hear your reflections and insights. By hitting that like button and subscribing to our channel, you become a part of our growing community of jazz enthusiasts. Share this voyage with your friends, drop a comment, and together, let's ensure that the rich dialogue around jazz continues to flourish and inspire. Till next time, keep the jazz alive. Bye for now.